Alright, everybody. Time for the conclusion, most likely, of Ocarina of Time. Make a bridge. Thank you. Alright, so I can either use dense fire. Fire arrow. Oops. Alright, so which one is it? Let me go up memory here. I think it's this one. Oh yeah. Alright, so do I need to use a special arrow? Or do I just shoot it with any arrow? Alright, it appears it needs a special arrow. Oh, I think it's the light arrow. Yep. I think I skipped it. Breaks the seals and whatnot. Alright, I remember where the golden gauntlets are. It's in the shadow one. I think it's funny that you really don't have the silver gauntlets for that long. Maybe like an hour? Thank you. Light Temple, or back out and go get the health upgrade, which I'm probably gonna get to first. Might as well do this on the way. Easily the best upgrade in the game. If there were achievements or something for this game, that'd be one thing, but 100% playthroughs really just take way more time than are really necessary to really enjoy the game. Some of the things you have to do for a 100% playthrough are just, they're not difficult, they're just mentally frustrating, put it that way. Okay, probably do the forest next. Thank you. remember this one. Fairy. Thank you. So I'll probably need the hammer. Guessing. Hammer. pretty good. You know, it really helps to know what to do in this game. That's my biggest takeaway from this playthrough. All this stuff was pretty difficult the first time I played it, but, you know, you beat it more than a handful of times. It's kind of routine, but it's fun. This is relaxing. So it is the light temple with the fuckery. That was quick. What am I up to? 29 minutes? It's not horrible. Okay. So should I fill the bottle up with a fairy? Or should I get it like a magic potion or something? I could probably fill it with a green potion. Since then, it's never happened. You never know. I could have an epic series of fumbles. Who knows? Alright. I'm trying to decide if this is the point of no return or if it's up ahead. I think it's up ahead more. chest or something here. I don't know. This area looks like in the 3DS version. So I know that that game has like all new textures for it. I'm never gonna use bomb chews again, so I'm gonna see if I can cheese them out. Future. If I ever do play the 3DS version, that'd probably be the way to do it. Alright, buddy boy, Ganondorf, here we go. Issues or not. I know the last time I played, I was able to do it without falling down here once, so. Okay. Thought that was the way to go. Guess you gotta go through the door. Oh yeah, there's more stairs to climb, that's right. Yeah, I really wonder what this hallway looks like in the 3DS version. But it looks really, new, fresh. Alright. So what weapons do I need? Arrows. Trying to remember if anything else hurts him. I'll keep the Ocarina. Because if I need a pause, I can always pop the Ocarina out and it'll pause things. Although that's kind of silly. Should I equip something else in that slot? I don't really know of anything else I can use. Except for the hammer. Everything else would just get in the way. Alright.
Alright, I fucked that up.
God damn it. Still haven't died yet. See, green blood. So now this part, I don't remember exactly what to do. So this might suck. And is the reason why I made sure to have at least three fairies. Because if I'm going to screw up, it's going to be on this fight.
Thank you.
To die in that segment. We'll run out of time. Especially if we screw up a couple times on the fighting the two dudes. And then unfortunately if you don't have enough time and you get caught by the grabber guy. But otherwise, if you just stay on her ass the whole time, you should be fine. Final battle. Alright, here comes Ganon. Let's see if I got my loadout set. I don't think you can cheese him with bombs. I think he stuns if you throw a Deku Nut. Alright, this is good. Is the only upside to getting the giant big Goron sword thing, because instead of having to use the hammer, which I do now, you could use the sword instead. Thank you. Alright, and he returns in Twilight Princess and I think Breath of the Wild, right? I don't remember if Breath of the Wild takes Twilight Princess into account. But Twilight Princess is supposed to be a direct sequel to this timeline. If I remember correctly. I thought it was pretty funny too. I didn't have to use the light arrows. I was like, when am I going to use these light arrows? So I fired one at them just to see what would happen. And I think that's the strategy that they intend for you to use, is to stun them with the light arrows and then swoop behind, swoop around behind and get a good stab in at the tail. But I just used Dark Souls strats and just hugged his ass. Is a good thing to go back in time. Nobody wants to live in the destroyed world anymore. Like, a lot of the people are dead, right? Several areas of Hyrule are completely destroyed. Alright, now here's the part of my playthroughs where I talk about what I thought about the game, all that shit. My opinion, when I was a kid, was that this is the best game I've ever played, and probably will be for a long time. Since then, I've obviously played some arguably better games, but if you look at what this game did before many of those games, this game is outstanding in that regard. A lot of people have debates about whether Ocarina of Time or Majora's Mask is better. Me personally, I couldn't beat Majora's Mask as a kid. Well, I probably could. But the wind back time mechanic really pissed me off, and I was coming off of a high of playing this game like 10 times, and then I didn't even know Majora's Mask existed. And then I walk into a GameStop, and I'm like, ooh, what is this? And the guy behind the counter says, oh, that's Majora's Mask. You've never heard of it? And I'm like, no, what is this? And he goes, well, did you ever play Ocarina of Time? And I said, oh, yeah. 10, 15, 20 times, yeah. You know, 100% of the game, several times. Played it constantly for months. And the guy's like, oh, you'll love Majora's Mask. Get this. It's the same engine. Back when people didn't really talk about game engines. So this guy was a nerd. And he was talking about, it's like the same build, except I think a couple of the graphical things are updated. And it's like a lot of the same similar characters. Of course, you get a couple new areas and some new people. But there are some people that cross over. But he said it's a sequel to Ocarina of Time. I think it came out in, was it 2000 or 99? It was either a year or two after this came out. And he said it's a completely new game, but it uses all the mechanics of Ocarina of Time. And I'm like, oh, that sounds badass. So I bring it home, I start playing it, And then I think like an hour and a half later, it says that you lose and you have to start over or something. So I'm like, what? What is this? Because apparently this big moon or something crashes into the planet, kills everything. But in order to stop that, you have to play a song on your ocarina that rolls back time, and then you have a certain amount of time to complete several tasks, because when you roll back time, it sends you back to your like main house, but you get to keep a lot of the tools that you got in that time frame. So it's like I don't know, there's a movie, but I forgot what the movie was, but so it's kind of Groundhog Day, kind of Zelda, I don't know. So I couldn't wrap my head around the fact that the game is punishing me for not knowing where to go. So I kept having to play the goddamn ocarina, and I don't know, it was just pissing me off. So I decided, screw this. I think I put a solid, like, 2 hours into it, and there was really not easy access to guides at that time. Like, you couldn't pull up your cell phone and just look up a guide. Like, you had to go on the computer, look the shit up, and then, like, print out some shit on paper and bring it back to your room, you know, because people didn't have computers in their room or laptops really back then. So, I mean, I'm like, this game is a huge pain in the ass, and it really sullied my taste for Ocarina of Time as well, because I'm like, how did they go from this to this, you know what I mean? And I don't know, I didn't play a Zelda game for a long time after that. Although I did eventually play one of the Zelda games on the Game Boy, and I did enjoy that one. But then all the games after that had like the cartoony vibe or whatever, and I wasn't really into that, because I'm like, it felt like a step down. I mean, the games ran better, but I don't know, it felt like a step down. It's like the creators acknowledge that, oh, this is a game for kids. It's like, well, yeah, but I mean, just because you're not a kid doesn't mean you can't enjoy it either. So I don't know, it like really leaned into the kid angle, whereas this game was, I mean, it had more mature elements. You know, like, there's a good story, there's, like, you know, the villain and all that shit. I don't know. I'm not a writer, but all I know is the story of this game felt epic. The story of Majora's Mask felt like the creators were like, hey, I have an idea, but hear me out. And then people were like, eh, alright, whatever, let's build it. You know? So they're riding off the high of Ocarina of Time. Massive, favorable reputation, and they put out Majora's Mask. And that end screen in itself shows how much effort they know they put into this game. And of course here you get Link meeting with Zelda after all this mess goes, and they probably both retain their memory, I'm guessing. So is she looking for Ganondorf? What the hell is she doing? Oh yeah, it's the freeze frame. Okay. The end. Alright, so now I have a decision to make. Do I go backwards and play Link to the Past next? Or do I bite the bullet and see if I can beat Majora's Mask? I've never beaten it before. That might be pretty fun. Especially after playing this. I'm all warmed up, you know? If I do play Majora's Mask, I'm gonna have to try it first. because the way I'm playing this is, it's obviously emulated, but I tweaked a few settings to get it to look the way it does. You know, some upscaling, upresing, and stuff like that. So I'm gonna have to see if these settings carry over to Majora's Mask, because that did have some graphical artifacts with the original configuration. But I fixed those with some tweaks. So, yeah. So I'm probably gonna get this shit encoded, mull it over, and decide. Link to the Past or Majora's Mask? I figure Link to the Past would probably take me maybe 15, 20 hours to beat, whereas Majora's Mask, I have no idea. I think it's supposed to be the same runtime as Ocarina of Time, but I have Ocarina of Time down to a science by now, more or less. It's mainly just fumbles on my part that really set me back, but I don't know how long Majora's Mask would take, because I don't know where shit is. You know, I'm probably going to do Majora's Mask. I owe it to myself to at least try it. I do credit myself as a giant Zelda fan, after all. I have beat Zelda 1 and 2 with cheats, because those are on the NES. It's practically impossible unless you sit there for hours and play it. Because, you know, with the continuing and all that. Link to the Past I beat. Ocarina of Time, obviously. Kind of rage quit Majora's Mask back in the day, but that was a long time ago. I forgot what the Game Boy one I played was. It was a Game Boy Color. No, it was a 3DS. Was it a 3DS? No, it was a Nintendo DS. It wasn't even a 3DS. I don't remember which one that was, though. And then I played Twilight Princess. I got a used GameCube. Like, I want to say 8 years ago. And I played, you know, Smash Brothers, Mario Kart, Zelda. And I played a couple other games. I think I played a Star Fox game. I don't know, I have a bunch of shit in a drawer behind me. And then I played, so yeah, Twilight Princess, and then that's it. I'm still waiting to get a Switch. I know it's inevitable that they're going to release an updated version of the Switch. That's when I'm going to get it. So, yeah. So that's good. That's the end of this playthrough. It'll end my walk down memory lane there. I think I'm definitely going to try to see if I can play Majora's Mask. I'm feeling it now. I'm psyched. Pumped. Alright, so what happens if I skip this? Can I skip this? Alright, so this is why there's no post-game. Because they have this end screen, and if you turn the console off and turn it back on, which you have to do, or you could do the reset glitch, where you press everything on the controller, it starts you back before the Ganon fight. Or before the Ganondorf fight, I think. So, you can go back and 100% the game before you beat it again. Alright, but I'm not going to do that. So, this playthrough's over. Good shit. Hour and 12 minutes, including the credits. Very good time for Ganon, for me. That's it. Alright, peace out. Check out Majora's Mask if I beat it by now, or if I started playing it by now. That'll be interesting. All right, peace.